Welcome to the Grok Shop. In a previous video, I showed how you can build an SDK package for Gitea for your Synology disk station. Now, while that package works good, and if you use a built-in database like MariaDB, you should have no issues. You could have issues with it automatically starting up or not starting up if you're using PostgreSDB in a Docker container. And so I decided to check this out a little bit and make some mods to the Gitea open source. And probably throw up a pull request for these guys at some point here, but I'll show you guys a little bit of the debugging thought process as well as the solution thought process. So the first thing I'm gonna do is look at the logs from Gitea itself, and we'll head over to user local Gitea, Gitea log, and in there, there'll be a file called gitea.log. And we'll just crack that open, head to the bottom. And we can see right at the bottom a fail to initialize ORM engine, which is a little curious because the ORM must be built in. I don't have an external ORM layer. So I know it must be something related to the database because object relational mapping is used for databases. So like a lot of other Linux platforms, Synology has switched over to using Upstart startup management. So we'll look at the var log Upstart logs. There'll be a log in here for each package or process that Upstart manages. So here's the one for Gitea. I'll just take a look at that and see if it shows anything useful. I could see down here at 1858.31, Gitea was started, or at least it thinks it was started. Probably the log entry comes out before it actually completes the start process, which may not be the best implementation, but since there's no stop there and it's not running, we know something's wrong, but it doesn't really tell us much. Looking at etc init, we can see all the Upstart comp file, so we'll just check out the one for Gitea here. Package control gitea.conf. So in here we can see the dependencies. The package will start if Docker and Git are both running first, and that would seem correct. Now those get set in the SPK builder, so I'll show you guys where that is here. Just go to the info.in file, and you can see in here this field start dep services, start dependent services is Git and Docker. And so this determines how the comp file is set. So the default is it comes with a Git dependency. I added the Docker dependency. If you have another database like MariaDB or SQLite, you may want to make sure those processes are running if you have any problems. So we can actually see the order that everything starts up in by listing the Upstart log folder with the time switch, the -t switch here. And you can see the one at the very top is the last one to start, which is actually Gitea. And down below there, we can see Docker's going off together well before Gitea, and also Git itself has gone off even before that. So everything looks pretty good here, and it would seem that startup order is not the problem, right? Yeah, it might seem that way, but my thinking is Postgres is a Docker container, and even though the Docker itself has started up, the container itself maybe hasn't fully initialized. I didn't see how to control that through the developer guide here from Synology. Or further delay the process in any way. I read through some of this information in pretty good detail. They have one thing called pre-check startup and start-stop status that seemed like it might help. And so I did explore this a little bit. I wrote a little script. I'll show you guys what I did here. By the way, I'll put a link to this doc below. So yeah, here we are back in the SDK area. And if you go into this folder called scripts, you'll see these pre-canned scripts they give you, which you can actually modify, and they control installation, upgrade, and start, stop, and all that. And so you would think you could do some stuff here. I actually went in and modified the start area to, here you can see, to include a check for the port, which is 5433, using netstat. And if it wasn't ready yet, go to sleep for 3 seconds and keep trying. But for whatever reason, this didn't work. Seemed like a good idea, but I don't think, my assumption is that they don't want you to delay the process. So they've got like a flow established, and when you don't respond in a certain amount of time, like their manager is probably getting upset about that and just crapping out. That's my theory about what's going on. I don't really know, but makes sense to me. By the way, I would be remiss if I didn't mention the normal place to fix these kind of issues is in the pre-start script area in the comp file. But unfortunately, Synology overwrites the comp files every time you reboot. So there must be a way to affect what it overwrites the file with, but I just don't know that. If somebody comes along who knows the secret sauce there, do tell. So now I'll head over to my Go projects area where I've cloned off the Gitea repository. Before diving in, let's take a quick look at the log again and take note of the file init.go and line number 60 where the error is emitting into the log file. So moseying on over to the Gitea repo on GitHub, we'll make our way into the routers folder and check out init.go and line 60. And that should look familiar. There's our log entry that's causing us so much headaches. So what we need to do is probably have some more flexibility in the connection. So I'm going to replace this code here with this code here. So all I've done here is basically add a retry loop. So it'll go through 10 times and it'll rest for 3 seconds between each attempt. And if it gets to the end, it'll fail just like before. Otherwise, you have 9 more chances to connect, and we'll see here how effective this is in a minute. Of course, this is just an initial draft. I wouldn't submit the pull request without checking to see if they want constants in the config file. And also, they probably want a full test battery run, but worry about all that stuff later, right? So just backing up a bit, this is the guide I followed for downloading the source. I'll put this link below. It actually worked right off the bat, which I love. It doesn't always work that way, but this one did. And here's the build command that I used. And you can even run it locally, which I tried out. That worked fine too. But everything went off without a hitch. And I did the build and then went ahead and built the SDK. Now I'm going to try to install it here. By the way, I built against master or the tip of the code. You may want to build against a pre-release or more stable branch. So far, I haven't had any issues, but it's just really a trial run here anyway. Here you can see some of the other SDKs I previously built. And the one with Grokman is the one I built here for this project. So yeah, going ahead and running the package so we can test it out and have it running. It does, I believe, need to be running when you reboot the machine in order for it to come back up. And you can see it's working fine. Okay, so moment of truth. We'll go through an expedited reboot process here. So just a quick check to confirm the site's down there. It is down. And after the reboot, we'll just sit tight for a few minutes. As remember, we have that 3-second delay in each loop because we needed a little more time. And we'll wait and see if it comes alive. They typically come alive on their own here. And there we go. When it says open like that, that means it is running. We'll just refresh the site. And yep, there we go. Confirm everything looks good so far. So heading back over to the Gitea log and strolling to the bottom of the file. And there we can see our log entries from our new code. And it looks like it took 3 tries. So at least 9 more seconds, probably plus a little change, right? Well, that went well. So I'll put my build up in case anybody needs it on a temporary basis. Also, I'll post up in the description the status of any PRs that I do on this. That's how it's done. Thanks for watching.